Greetings everyone. What a beautiful day. We are going to be looking at the Holy Spirit. As we start this session, let's start with a prayer. Father, we thank you. We bless you, mighty King of glory. We bless you for your goodness. We bless you for your mercies. We bless you for your grace. We thank you, mighty King of glory, that awesome Father, you have given us your peace. You have given us your grace. We welcome your Holy Spirit to come and teach us. We welcome your Holy Spirit to come and have his way today. We welcome your Holy Spirit to come and take over our mind, our spirit, our soul. Come, we need you, Spirit of the Most High God. In the times that we are in, we need you daily. We need you, Spirit of the Most High God, that you will come and help us. Come and teach us. I remove you and myself, and I ask you to come and teach us today. Come and revive us. Come and refresh us. Come and restore. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm going to be looking at the Holy Spirit today. And I know in the times that we are in and with what is happening, I mean around the world, I know we have had challenges, but the times we are in are times of uncertainty. There are times of distress. There are times of challenge. There are times of not being able to know what is going to happen tomorrow. But we as children of God have been given this Spirit. We have been given the Holy Spirit. We have been given his presence, the Holy Spirit, to help us navigate, to be our compass, to be our comforter, to be our encourager, to teach us, the Holy Spirit to guide us. I want to start by using first the reference scripture of Jeremiah chapter 33, and I want to look at verse 2 and verse 3. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 2 and verse 3. That says, the Lord, the maker of the earth, the Lord that formed it, to establish it, the Lord is his name. Call unto me, I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. We can look here and see the word of God is saying that this is him. He says to us, call unto me, I will answer you. I will show you great and mighty things that you know not. Because the Lord knows there are so many things in our time right now that we are not in a place to know, or we have not been even given the knowledge of. But we do have the Holy Spirit who can give us the knowledge. We do have the Holy Spirit who can give us understanding. We do have the Holy Spirit who can give us revelation. We have this Spirit of God that has been given to us. And today I want to encourage you as child of God to draw near and closer to the Holy Spirit in the times we are in. The times we are in are nearing the times of the return of our King, or of our groom, which is Christ Jesus. Our risen King is soon coming back for his church and for the bridegroom. And the times we are in also, you have, and I believe you know, that the enemy has also geared up. The enemy knows his time is short, as the word of God is saying. He knows his time is short. And the enemy is causing every havoc that can happen under the sun or on this earth. And we as children of God have to gear up. And I want to encourage you in the times that we are in. Are you daily listening to the instruction of the Holy Spirit? I hope you have heard me. I'm saying daily listening to the instruction of the Holy Spirit. We have to get to a place whereby we don't dwell on the instructions of last week of the Holy Spirit. We don't dwell in the last place that we found ourselves with the Holy Spirit. Are you daily drawing into a relationship with the Holy Spirit? Are you daily depending on the Holy Spirit? Have you opened up your eyes daily? Have you opened up your spiritual ears daily? Have you allowed the Holy Spirit to give you spiritual understanding, wisdom, knowledge of the things that are happening in the times that we are in? Because if we, at this particular time, if we don't draw closer to the Holy Spirit, we are going to find ourselves falling away. We are going to find ourselves in the worst of places. I want to encourage you as a child of God, as I'm going to be outlining several scriptures about the Holy Spirit. I want to encourage you at this time to draw closer to the Holy Spirit. You might have drawn closer to the Holy Spirit, but I want to encourage you to daily listen to the instructions of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is available to guide us. The Holy Spirit is available to comfort us. The Holy Spirit is available to direct us. The Holy Spirit, you know what? is available to even give you inspiration, wisdom into so many areas of your life. But have you asked him? He says here in his word that call unto me and I will answer you. He says, call unto me. Are we surely calling? Are we calling unto the Holy Spirit? Because this is the Old Testament. But we in the New Testament, Jesus says, he's leaving us with a comforter. He's leaving us with the Holy Spirit. He is encouraging us here to call unto him. Are we calling unto him? Are you right now calling unto him in the situation that you are in? Are you calling him? Because the word of God says here, call unto me. He says, I will answer you. You know, he doesn't say, I won't or I'll think about it. He says, yeah, I will answer you. And apart from answering you, he says, I will show you. Okay, so the Holy Spirit is ready to show you. When you call unto him, he will answer you, and he promises that he will show you. He will show you areas of your life that the word of God says, great and mighty things which you know not. So in the times that we are in, that so many things are happening, uncertain, so many things on every corner are happening, are we calling unto the Holy Spirit to show us these things? Or we are walking like the world, that are walking uncertain? We have to walk with the Holy Spirit and daily depend on him. He will show us things. We ought not to walk like the world, whereby things are happening to you accidentally. You don't know what and where and how. The Holy Spirit is willing to show you. The Holy Spirit is willing to come unto you and to show you daily, to prepare your heart, to show you daily what is going on, to give you wisdom in the area you need wisdom, to give you knowledge in the area you need knowledge, to give you understanding in the area you need understanding, to give you joy, peace in the area you need joy, peace. But the condition is, call unto me, call unto him, and don't get tired of calling unto him. And the times we are in, we are going to see a lot of discouragement, because when the enemy is attacking on every side and intensifying the attacks, we find ourselves in a place of so much discouragement. I am encouraging you at this time, no matter where you find yourself, call unto the Holy Spirit. He is listening and he yearns to hear you call him. The Holy Spirit is a gentleman. He's a gentle spirit. He is waiting for you to listen to him and to call to him. I'm going to be reading several scriptures here that I want to ground this area of the Holy Spirit. Now, when we look at 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 7, it says here, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, we can see that there is definitely freedom. If you are in a place of bondage, have you called upon the Holy Spirit to give you freedom, to bring this freedom in your spirit? Are you at the place of anxiety? Have you entered into a place of depression? Are you in a place of sadness? The word of God says, call unto him. He will give you freedom. You know, it is so easy to look everywhere for freedom. But if you are a child of God and you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit is available. He has been given to us to give us freedom. You find yourself in a place of being bound, call unto the Holy Spirit to deliver you. If you found yourself into a place of physical affliction, whereby your body is going under attack, physically sickness are coming to your body, call unto the Holy Spirit. He says here, he is the Spirit of freedom. He will give you freedom. When we look at another scripture here, Romans chapter 15 and verse 13, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Three things that I note here in this scripture in Romans: joy, peace, and hope. So we can see here that God of hope is able to fill us with his joy and his peace in times like this, in times of distress, in times of sadness, in times of and such challenging times that we are in. The word of God promises that this same Holy Spirit is available to give us peace. You know, apart from giving us peace, I always like to go another level further. Rest, you know, you can have peace, but it's also important that you also get to a place of rest. We can see in the word of God where the Lord talked to the children of Israel and told them they would rest on all sides around them. They will not be attacked. It is so important, even us as children of God, to move from the place of just having peace to a place of having rest. You know, and to get to that place of having rest, you have to constantly be guarding your peace. Guard your peace jealously. You know, I always say joy and peace, you guard it jealously. And you know what? The Holy Spirit is available. I'm not saying all the time you are going to find yourself in that same place. But if you depend on the Holy Spirit daily and you ask the Holy Spirit, Spirit of the Lord, today I ask you to give me peace. I ask you to give me peace in every decision that I'm going to make. I ask you to give this family peace. I ask that every area that I walk in, I will walk in with your presence, okay? So that is also another level. You know, you go from just having peace and you go from just having rest to you bringing the presence of God to everywhere you go with peace. Every place you enter in, you enter with the presence of peace. Where you find trauma, you bring peace. Where you find people in distress, you enter into that room and the presence of peace enters into that room and is ushered in. We have to get to a place whereby when we don't just have the spirit of peace in us and rest, but we can also usher it, okay, to others around us. When we enter a room, when we talk to someone, when we have a conversation to someone, that we can be able to usher in this peace, this overwhelming peace that is not ours, but the peace that comes from the Lord. Let me tell you something. The world does not have this peace. This peace is only given to us as children of God and originates and comes with the Spirit of God. So every morning, every day, if you can, I want to encourage you to ask the Lord to give you this peace. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you this peace. And when you have this peace, receive rest. Okay? Apart from having peace, also rest in the Lord. Rest knowing that the Lord has got you. Rest knowing that the Lord is covering you. Rest in the Lord and not be shaken every time. Don't allow yourself to be shaken when situations are coming your way. Financial situations, physical situations, spiritual situations. Find rest in the Holy Spirit. Find yourself resting in the Holy Spirit. You know, when it gives me such a picture when the disciples were with Jesus and they were in a boat. And I know all of you know about that story. So now they are in the boat and the storm starts. When the storm started, Jesus is resting. Okay. Jesus is not just sleeping. Jesus, it's not like Jesus can't feel the storm shaking them. The sheep, but Jesus is in a place of rest. And the disciples of Jesus are in such a panic. They are wondering, how can this guy be resting when all this is happening around us? And we can get to that place of rest even when the storms of life are shaking us, are shaking around us. You can still get to a place of rest. And you know who gives us that rest? It is the Holy Spirit. Now, it also talks about joy. The joy, you know, then the joy that the world gives, but the joy that the Holy Spirit gives. And joy is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. Being a fruit means it's a result of the Holy Spirit. The moment we receive the Holy Spirit in us and He daily grounds us and He daily puts our roots deeper in Him, we will bring out the fruit of joy. And we ought to also be in a place whereby we can tap into that joy. That is what the Word of God is saying here. In the times that we are in, we can tap into that fruit of joy. And remember, the fruit is not for the tree to eat. The fruit is for others around us to be able to eat. So we can tap into that joy of the Lord. But also when we enter a room, when we speak with someone, when we interact with someone, they should be able to eat from that fruit of joy. Another one that we can see here is hope. You know, hope. The Holy Spirit brings hope. It says here, overflowing with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Overflowing with hope for the future. Hope that the Lord is going to rescue us. Hope that the Lord has got us. hope that the Lord has provided for us, hope that it's already done, and that the Word of God is saying we have to overflow, overflow, not just to have hope, but to overflow in this hope that the Lord our God is with us, will never leave us, will never forsake us. We have hope for tomorrow, that tomorrow will be better. We have hope that tomorrow the Lord will keep on providing. We have hope that tomorrow, even as today, as he has done it, tomorrow also we have hope that the Lord will protect us. In the times where we see lawlessness, a lot of lawlessness, insecurity happening, and I'm talking about physical and spiritual insecurity, so much is happening, so much attacks are happening around us, around our homes, around our cities, around the world. We can only find security. Let me tell you something, you can put on the most security around your door, around your gate. But let me say this to you, the first security is the Holy Spirit. The first security is God. He says in his word that he can command and send forth his angels to guard us, to protect us. And that is our God. That is the first security. We can hope in protection first through our God. I'm not saying leave your doors open. Of course, I'm not saying that. But our first hope must be in the Lord. You know, you can put on your alarms if you want to. But let me tell you something. I have seen people with the highest security broken into. So our first important hope is in the Lord. He is our protector. He is our guide. When we go further and look at John chapter 14, and we can see verse 26, it says, "But the advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things, will remind you of everything that I've said to you." This was Jesus saying to the disciples. And it's the same to us. The Holy Spirit, the advocate, this one who the Father has sent to us, the Bible says he will teach us all things. He will teach us all things. Now, you hear the word all things? It is so important to understand that all things, not just a few things, but all things. So for the Holy Spirit to teach us all things, are we running to him to teach us these things? Or are we running to the world system? Are we running to friends to be the ones to teach us these things? Are we running all over the place to be taught? Because the Word of God promises that this same Spirit of God will teach us all things. Is it your marriage? The Holy Spirit is willing to teach you. Is it raising godly children? The Holy Spirit is willing, and I'm saying willing here according to the Word of God. He says he will teach us all things. Which area? Is it finances? Is it work? Which area of your life? Is it relationships? The Holy Spirit is available to teach us all things. And remember, to also remind us, okay, of everything that Jesus Christ has said, or that the Word of God has laid out. This same Holy Spirit will remind us of things that have been laid out in the Word of God. You know, several times I've gotten to a place whereby I literally, you know, when you are in such a fix and you just need to make a quick decision about something, and believe me, you don't have time to go to a Bible and check it out, and you don't have time to call a friend to give you advice. And you know what I've done every single time? Gone to the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit has reminded me of something. It might be a testimony, a battle that was won. It might be something that I had someone say how they overcome. It might be a scripture. But you know, that is the power of the Spirit of God that lives in us. And that is only by grace. But it has to be to a place whereby you yield into the Holy Spirit, whereby you are saying every time, "Holy Spirit, here am I give you my mind, I give you my heart, I give you my eyes, I give you everything. Guide me, lead me, lead me in this world that I'm in, lead me in this relationship, lead me, Holy Spirit." I am going to assure you that same Holy Spirit knows everything, and he will guide you in everything. Also, we can see here that the Holy Spirit here, Jesus knew very importantly the importance that the disciples had to receive the Holy Spirit. We can see also in Acts that Jesus definitely knew the importance that was behind the disciples receiving the Holy Spirit. We can see in Acts, and you can find it in chapter 2, when the disciples are waiting for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. They are eagerly waiting, but it's an instruction that Jesus told them. Jesus knew, you know, from the beginning when he was leaving his disciples, that these guys are not going to be able to manage. They will not be able to manage without this Spirit living in them. And we can see the baptism. They waited for the Holy Spirit. We can see men that were timid. We can see apostles or disciples of Christ that were timid, changing to become bold, receiving a spirit of boldness, standing out there in thousands of people to tell them about this Jesus that has died and resurrected. They were able to transform thousands in just a day after the Holy Spirit had come upon them. This same Holy Spirit gives us confidence, gives us boldness. These same men, before the Holy Spirit came down upon them, were the same men. And we can look at an example of Peter, who three times was able to say, "No, I don't know this man called Jesus." And this was the same timid man who, after receiving the Holy Spirit, became so confident. You know, became so confident. And these were the same men, from that character of timidness, or from being not confident, to becoming very confident, very bold to speak the word of God. So this same Holy Spirit is the one that gives us the boldness to speak the gospel to others, to tell others about the truth which is only in the word of God, to tell our family members in this time of December, whereby so many family members are going to be joining together. Yes, he gives us the boldness to tell others about this Jesus, to tell others about the good news. He gives you and I the boldness to testify about his goodness without fear, knowing that a life, another life can depend on it. Another life needs it. And this is the same Holy Spirit. Jesus knew that the disciples would not survive without the Holy Spirit. You know, when we look further, I can look at Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 30. "And don't grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption." The word of God here warns us not to grieve the Holy Spirit. What does it mean by grieving the Holy Spirit? You know, so many times, and I can easily give an example, so many times the Holy Spirit can, you know, warn you about something or tell you about something, and over you are doing something, you are repeating something over and over that you know is wrong. I don't know, it can be the smallest thing, it can be the biggest thing, but it's all sin at the end of the day. It can be lying, but in you hear the Holy Spirit saying, "Stop lying." Okay, so stop behaving like that. You can feel the Holy Spirit convicting you over and over and over and over, convicting you to stop doing that habit because it's not right in the eyes of God. And you know what? You reach a time whereby you are not listening to the Holy Spirit. You become fully unrepentant, resistant. You are grieving the Holy Spirit. So what happens after that? The Spirit of God, unfortunately, is a gentleman. He doesn't impose himself on us. He's going to have to leave. You know what happens when the Spirit of the Lord leaves? You are empty. You are so empty for any other spirits to come in and have residence. And you do not want to know. You do not want to know what is going to happen when the Holy Spirit leaves you as a child of God. Yes, the Holy Spirit can leave a child of God. And it's so important for us to be watchful when the Holy Spirit is convicting us, when the Holy Spirit is warning us about habits, habitual habits that we are doing over and over. You know, it is okay for you to repent, but remember also, repentance is all about turning 180 degrees away from what you were doing previously. When you ask the Holy Spirit to forgive you, and you humbly ask him to forgive you, it is also important to ask him to give you the grace to overcome that specific sin, that specific habit that you are doing over and over. And you know what I'm talking about. You feel it in your spirit that you are doing it over and over, and you are not happy about it, you know, and you even yourself become grieved about it. Then imagine the Holy Spirit. So it's so important that we listen to the Holy Spirit, and we quickly repent. Repent meaning for ask him to forgive you, but also ask him to give you the grace to change. Give you the grace to change from doing that habit and give him the permission to also convict you. We are all on this journey of salvation. We are not yet perfected, but remember, we have to be obedient and willing to listen to the Holy Spirit when he corrects us, when he rebukes us, and when he directs us. It is that very important. For who knows a person's thoughts except their own spirit within them? In the same way, no one knows the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. For who knows a person's thought except their own spirit within them? In the same way, no one knows the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. And that's 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 11. We can see here that it's the Holy Spirit who knows the thoughts of God. And it's the Holy Spirit who can reveal to us the thoughts of God towards our lives, towards our destiny, towards our purpose, towards our calling. It is only the Holy Spirit who can reveal to us the future. It is only the Holy Spirit who can prophetically bring to us the thoughts of our Father in heaven. Now imagine, as a child of God, walking without the Spirit of God, having grieved the Holy Spirit that he has left you. How are you going to walk? How are you going to be aware of things that are happening around you? You are going to be a Christian, but walking in the dark without being aware of what is happening. Things are going to be happening to you by surprise. Attacks are going to be happening around you without you having the guard to fight. The Holy Spirit is the one who knows the thoughts of the Father and is the one who brings these thoughts to us. He's the one who encourages us, okay? So he's the one who motivates us. He's the one who refreshes us. He's the one who revives us. And he draws this from the Father. And it's so important that we understand this from the Holy Spirit. You know, when I look at, as I was saying here in Psalms 143 verse 10, as I finish my last verse, teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit lead me on level ground. Teach me, and this was David asking at the Holy God to teach him, teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit lead me on level ground. Psalms 143 verse 10. This is so profound that David is asking the Lord to teach him. And I believe that even now, as children of God, we ought to ask the Holy Spirit to teach us, to teach us his way. Because let me tell you something, we fall away from his way. Ask the Holy Spirit daily, lead me, teach me in your way, lead me on level ground, that I will walk in your paths and that I will walk in your ways. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that we will depend on your Spirit. I pray for anyone right now who has drawn away, walked away, or moved further away from your Spirit. I pray for anyone right now, as you say in your word, rather we are cold or hot, but not lukewarm. I pray that anyone right now who is watching and who is listening, mighty Father, that we will draw closer to the Holy Spirit. We will desire for your Spirit. We will hunger for your Spirit. We will pray and yield our ears, our eyes, and allow our understanding to line up with the Holy Spirit. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you revive us again as your children. Revive our hearts, revive our spirit to be able to listen to the Spirit of the Most High God, to depend on the Spirit of the Most High God. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. So today I want to encourage you to listen, to yield, to ask. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you his understanding. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you his knowledge. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you wisdom. Depend daily on the instructions of the Holy Spirit. Forget about the instruction of yesterday, but go daily in the secret place of the Holy Spirit and ask him, lead me. Lead me, Holy Spirit, because I need you today. Have a blessed day, and may the Holy Spirit lead you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.